Hello all, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to discuss with you all the poet I Wandered Lonely as a Cloud, written by William Wordsworth. William Wordsworth was a very renowned English poet in the 1830s, and still now his fame has remained the same. William Wordsworth was a great nature lover, and his every poet contained nature as its main theme. So let's go through this poem to know its internal meaning. As you can see in the very title of this poem, there is a feeling of solitude, sadness and loneliness. And from it we can assume that the poet was in a sad mood at the beginning of this poem. This poem is all about the modification of poet's mood from a sad one to a happy one. Let's start. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high over vales and hills. Here the poet has compared himself to a cloud. Here, as we can see in the sky, the clouds float without any fixed motive, without any fixed destination. They just float freely. So the poet was also wandering lonely as a cloud. As a cloud only travels alone. The cloud floats on high over valleys and hills. Over means over, vales means valleys. So as the cloud floats on high over valleys and hills, the poet was also wandering lonely. When all at once he saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils. So while wandering lonely as a cloud, the poet encountered a crowd, a host of golden daffodils. So this is the point of meeting of the poet and the golden daffodils beside the lake beneath the trees. So this is the place of their meeting, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. So this is the condition of the daffodils. They were fluttering, they were tossing their heads in a sprightly manner, and they were dancing in the mild wind that was blowing, that is breeze. Continuous as the stars that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way. So here is the personification, is the simile of the daffodils. So the poet is telling that they were continuous as the stars that shine and twinkle on our galaxy. Milky Way is the name of our galaxy. And as you know, there are numerous stars in the galaxy that we cannot count. So the poet has compared the number of daffodils to the continuous stars that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way. They stretched in never-ending line along the margin of a bay. So along the margin of a bay, the daffodils were stretched in a never-ending line. Means never, they were stretched in never-ending line as far as the poet's vision can go. The poet can see that the daffodils were stretched in never-ending line. They were never-ending. 10,000 saw I at a glance. So the poet saw in a wink of his eye that there were 10,000 daffodils along the margin of a bay. Bay is a water body surrounded by land on three sides. And what the daffodils were doing? They were tossing their heads in a sprightly dance. So they were moving their heads in a rhythmical manner, in a very joyous mood. The waves beside them danced, but they outdid the sparkling waves in glee. As in the bay there are waves, the waves were tossing their heads in a sprightly manner. So this is the personification. And the daffodils were also dancing in a sprightly dance. So according to the poet, there was a competition going on between the waves and the daffodils. And as the poet, as the judge, the poet took the decision that the daffodils won the competition in glee, in happiness. The daffodils were able to make the waves lost in the competition. A poet could not but be gay in such a jocund company. Now the poet is referring to himself that in such a happy company of the waves, the daffodils, the never-ending daffodils, a poet could only be happy and nothing else. So here we can see that in the beginning of the poem, the poet was in a quite sad mood, but now he is happy. So the daffodils have been able to transform the poet's mood from the sad one to the happy one. In such a jocund company, means such a happy company, such a surrounded company, I gazed and gazed, but little thought what wealth the show to me had brought. So the poet was only watching, the poet was only noticing the golden daffodils, their spriteful dance, their beautiful scenery. The poet was only gazing at it. What wealth the show to me had brought. So here, the poet is comparing the scenery of the golden daffodils to the wealth. He is telling that the daffodils are so precious to him. Yes, the daffodils are so precious to him that daffodils have become able to transform his mood to the sad one to the happy one. So this is the wealth he has got. So he was only thinking that what wealth this beautiful scenery, this divine scenery has brought to me. For oft, when on my couch I lie, in vacant or in pensive mood. Here oft means often. So here the poet is stating his present condition. For often, when he lies on his couch. Couch means the cushion on the sofa in our homes. So the cushions are also called couch. When on my couch I lie, when on his couch the poet lies, in vacant or in pensive mood, in nothing within his mind and his vacant mood. He has nothing in his mind to think about, to talk about, nothing. In a pensive mood or in a such a free mood. Okay, they flash upon that inward eye. So when he sits on his couch, when he lies on his couch in a vacant or in a thoughtful mood, the daffodils, the scenery of the daffodils flash upon that inward eye. Inward eye means mind. So he remembers the daffodils, which is the bliss of solitude. Here solitude means loneliness, bliss means happiness. So here he is telling that when the daffodils flash in my inward eye, I feel very happy, because when I am lonely, the daffodils are my friends. Daffodils are my companions to make my mood happy. And then my heart with pleasure fills and dances with the daffodils. And after that, the poet who was sad, who was lonely, begins to be happy, starts to become gay, and his heart fills with pleasure, immense pleasure, and he and his heart start dancing with the golden daffodils. So this is all about the poem. This poem is totally a nature-based poem, and the gist of this poem is transforming the poet's mood from a sad one to a happy one. Here the poet is trying to convince the healing power of nature. The daffodils, which is the component of nature, has been able to transform poet's sad mood to the happy mood. So I hope that you have enjoyed this video. Thank you.